This video is called Similar Polygons. This video is 3 slides long, and this first slide you actually do not have on your note sheet. So feel free to sit back and relax and just watch and listen, or if you want to copy some of it down in the margin, you certainly can. This is kind of hard because I'm here and you're at home, and so when I ask you to think about what the word congruent means to you, I don't really have a chance to hear your answer. But hopefully, if I do ask what does congruent mean to you, you can think of basically congruent meaning exactly the same. That you can't even read. Hopefully you think of it as being the same or equal. In this case, the two stars are exactly the same. The sides are all the same length. The angles are all the same measure. So exactly the same. Congruent means equal. That is the congruent symbol, an equal sign with a squiggly above it. Then asking, what does the word similar mean to you? A lot of students in the past have said almost the same or looking the same but different. And really, hopefully, you can think of similar as being the same shape, different sizes. Same shape, different size. This smart board is really struggling. All right, I just realigned it. Hopefully that'll help for the future. So similar, same shape, different size. So you can see that one star is bigger than the other. And all you'd have to do is if it grew the same amount, it would able to end up being identical as the original one or congruent, or it could end up being bigger, or it could even end up being really, really small. So similar, they're the same shape but different sizes. And the thing is that they'd have to, it just has to change in the same amount in all directions. So let's keep going. So it's kind of asking what two conditions must be satisfied in order to say that two polygons are similar. Well, we have to compare two things. We have to compare the angles. Looks like the smart board isn't doing too much better. And we have to compare the side lengths. All right. So the thing is that the angles have to be the same. They have to be congruent. If you've got two triangles that are similar, the angle measures have to be the same. It's the side lengths that change, because it's when the side lengths grow and shrink, that's when the size of the shape changes. But the thing is, the side lengths have to be proportional. That means the side lengths have to change by the same amount. All right, I was able to make that a little bit neater. So just know, to prove if something's similar or not, two shapes are similar, the angles have to be equal or congruent, and the side lengths have to be proportional, which means they change by the same amount. You're going to be checking something that's called a scale factor. You'll learn about that in just a minute. Let's look at the first example here. It asks if the following figures are congruent, similar, or neither. Well, if you take a look at it, let's start with looking at the angles. I've got a right angle and a right angle, so those match up. And then in the bottom left-hand corner, these are both marked with one arc each, so that means they're the same. Even though I don't know how many degrees these angles actually are, because they each have one arc, I know they represent the same amount. And then lastly, in the lower right-hand corner, they both have two arc marks each. So this shows that the angles, it shows that the angles are equal. So now we have to look at the side lengths. I notice a 3 matches up with a 3, a 4 matches up with a 4, and a 5 matches up with a 5. So this looks like the side lengths are exactly the same. So since the angles are congruent and the side lengths are exactly the same, we can conclude that the two figures are in fact congruent. They are the exact same shape. So we can say they are congruent to each other. And this one, it kind of makes sense, because when you look at the two pictures, they do look like they're the exact same triangle. And by looking at the angles and looking at the side lengths, we confirmed that they are. Let's try this next one. It asks if the following figures are congruent, similar, or neither. Well, this one I think is fairly obvious because when you look at them, they clearly don't look the same. The one on the left looks like a parallelogram. The one on the right looks like a square. So without really doing any work, you can rule out the fact that they're congruent. Then similar, remember, to be similar, they have to be the same shape. They're just maybe different sizes. These clearly aren't the same shapes either. Like we said, one's a parallelogram, one's a square. So I think you could conclude pretty quickly that these shapes are not congruent and they're not similar. All right, one more example to go. Now this one's interesting. I don't know the names of these shapes. They have four sides, so I'll call them quadrilaterals, and they look like they're the same shape. It's just the one on the left looks a lot bigger than the one on the right. So I know automatically that I can't say that the shapes are congruent because they're not the same size. They may be the same shape, but they're not the same size. So what we're gonna do is spend some time and see if they're similar to each other. So remember, we have to look at two things. We have to see if the angles are the same, and we have to see if the side lengths are proportional. Let's start with the angles. It looks like on the left-hand side I have one arc. On the left-hand side of my small one, I have one arc. At the tops of each shape, there's two arcs each. On the right-hand side of each shape, there's four arcs each. And at the bottom of each shape, there are three arcs each. So we just confirmed that the angles are in fact congruent. So now let's take a minute and look at my side length pairs. I want to match these up. It looks like the 6 would match with the 3, the 8 would match with the 4, the 10 will match with the 5, and the 12 will match with the 6. So we have to figure out if they change by the same amount. Well, let's think about it. How do you get from a 10 to a 5? You divide by 2. How do you get from a 5 to a 10? You multiply by 2. If all the other side length pairs work in that same way, where going from left to right, you divide by 2, and from going from right to left, you multiply by 2, we will have similar shapes. So what I did here, I paused it and wrote it because for some reason the smart board works better if I write on it while it's paused. So take a second and catch up. All I did was make fractions or ratios out of my pairings. The 10 went with the 5, the 6 went with the 3, the 8 went with the 4, and the 12 went with the 6. These all can simplify down to a 2. If I wrote them the other way and did 5 over 10, 3 over 6, 4 over 8, and 6 over 12, they would have all simplified to 1/2. So what we just showed here is that all the sides changed by the same amount. So we've proven that the side lengths are proportional. So therefore, these shapes are similar. A side note, in a future video, you're going to be asked to find a scale factor. That's what we did here. Since all the side lengths changed by 2, 2 would be our scale factor. You'll get that in more detail in a video later on tonight.